Many may tell you that a woman's voice is a awra, but what less may be able to tell you is that the mahr is a gift the husband owes a wife that, if not given in completion before or during the marriage, remains a debt that he owes her, including after a divorce. Many may tell you that a woman's most important act of worship is wearing hijab. Few may be able to tell you is that in Islamic history, there are court cases in which a woman who was the victim of domestic violence would go to a judge, and the judge would order that the husband, because of his abuse, be physically assaulted in retaliation. And of course, she could have a faskh, or a dissolution of the marriage. Many may cite scholarly discussions on whether or not women should give lectures in public settings, but few could tell you about women's economic rights in Islam, including an inheritance. She may inherit more than a man, the same amount as a man, or if a man inherits double, he's also required to financially support different women in his life. This list is unending. That speaks to what we've allowed to become our normative cultural discourse when related to women's issues. And unfortunately, because of this, we have a rise of zealous but completely untrained dawah influencers who cite a hadith related to women's issues with no context, with no commentary from literally centuries of scholarship. How are we even questioning why women wonder very sincerely, asking, but being worried to even ask, what a woman's rights and role even is? It is time right now for us as a community to come to a reckoning before Allah holds us accountable. Of course, there is personal responsibility, but there's also community accountability for the women who are converts who enter our religion and then leave it, for the daughters who are sexually assaulted and then live in fear and silence, for the women who have anxiety attacks when praying or listening to the Quran because of spiritual abuse, for the women who go to the imam seeking support because they are victims of domestic violence and who are told to just pray and be patient. And when she prays for protection and doesn't feel protected, she wonders why Allah isn't answering her. That's not Allah not listening. That's a community that isn't trained to support men, women, and children who go through all of this. We have incredible imams, sheikhas, and community organizations deeply invested. We simply need to streamline systems of accountability, hire women resident scholars at every single masjid, hire lawyers, social workers, therapists to streamline supporting members professionally so that it doesn't all fall on an imam who's trained in Islamic law, not mental health or relationship crises. Islam is incredible, and we owe it to our religion to reflect its beauty in our spaces.